If only you could hear the show before the show. Let's just go to JC.
I got a small problem, but I've learned to live with it. Good morning, I'm Jamie Cooper. Thank y'all for getting up with us. This is Athens in the AM on an absolutely glorious, what is that, Wednesday morning edition of the world's most popular program in Athens, Alabama on Highway 72, right next to Mojo Cooper and Company. Join me today, as always, on a Wednesday, Seth, every other Wednesday. What's up with the green? Did I miss out on getting the right color today?
All three of y'all? This is my Herbs and More shirt.
Yeah, Dom, what's shaking? Number two?
It's hump day. Ready.
I'm not going to answer that question. And D?
What's up, buddy?
You got any new books writing?
Yeah, working on some of them.
Speaking of books, we got somebody's got a much thicker book than you do.
Oh, okay. Ooh. Well,
that's right. Johnny just rode in on his Harley this morning. We'll check with him in just a moment. You got that book over there?
We do.
Yeah, it's right there. If you can't reach it. Yeah, I've read that whole thing.
Yeah.
Tomorrow or over the weekend.
But it's good.
I'm coming out with my own book. I'm in the process of writing it now. I just ain't got nowhere on it yet, but coming out with that. I've got a full house in here this morning watching, getting ready to play Judge Jamie. We'll do that and just say, yeah, happy birthday, Lil Dick Lauderdale.
Yes.
I forgot to meet you yesterday.
Thank you.
You know, it ain't, when you turn 50, boys, it ain't, because I used to be there, it ain't that it's, you know, it's just saying that you're 50, and it gets worser when you say that you're 60.
Oh, is it really?
Yeah, it does get worse. You don't feel no different. It's just saying, golly, I'm 60. Well, actually, I'm 61 now. Thought y'all'd never know it, would you?
No.
Zach, what's shaking with you? Anything?
Nothing much. Hey, what? I saw, Dennis Black had his age in the paper said 60, so I guess you are a little bit older than him.
Zach, what's the line on the Ole Miss game?
I think it's around 3-5.
I thought they said they moved up to 6. I can't believe Auburn's a 9-point over, 8 or 9 over LSU.
That's huge. I mean, starting at 11 o'clock Saturday, A&M, Mississippi State going.
What's the line in that game?
I'll be honest with you, I don't know.
Jim. Anybody know?
I don't know on that one. I'm guessing.
I'm going to pick Ole Miss, Mississippi State in an upset.
Arkansas,
and I'm going with Auburn.
I agree with that. Now I believe LSU will beat Auburn. Sorry, Brad.
Yeah, anyway, let's get this party started. Here's Gloria with an absolutely good Fiddler's Convention weather forecast, hopefully.
Whether it will be or not. Actually, we're about 56, 57 degrees out there. Good morning if you're watching in the Huntsville area this morning. And I do want to say today's going to be an absolutely beautiful day with high temperatures around 87, full sunshine. So just enjoy because those temperatures will be changing. Mm-hmm. That's Maddie reading something in the background or Roll Tide too. All right, tomorrow high temperatures of 88. We do have rain in the forecast today. Did say rain Thursday, rain Friday, but hopefully that's going to be moving out in the morning hours. So the Fiddler's Convention Friday will be A-OK. Saturday, gorgeous with temperatures of 71. That's going to look absolutely beautiful walking around Athens State. Gorgeous. And of course, this is that book. We're going to be talking to a man who likes cats. He's going to tell us all about this book, and it is, yes, quite thicker, D.
Yeah, I'm going to have to step up my game.
Is that the first time you've ever been told that somebody's got something bigger than you?
No.
Birthday boy.
Birthday boy.
That's what's shaking with you.
There you go.
Living the dream. What is this? He likes cats like lions?
Hey, don't forget, Hometown Market specials come out today in your area newspaper. You'll see them right here first in just a few minutes, so y'all stay tuned for that. Tom. Hey, anything else going on?
We're waiting for you to update us.
You look like you had something to say.
Oh, I'm about to come out on y'all.
Oh
Lord.
I'm going to do something y'all wouldn't expect me to do.
Uh-oh.
I've been keeping up a little bit of this Secret Service deal. This one was on hot seat. One of the greatest lines was, I wish you spend more time protecting the White House than you spend protecting your reputation. They're grilling her. You know, I'm not a big fan of the president, but
he should be safe.
He's got to be protected. You let a guy, how far did he get into the White House?
He went in the bottom floor.
It's like 150 feet.
Yeah.
I mean, and then they said a guy got on an elevator with him, a convicted felon with a gun that the Secret Service allowed on.
That's
so, here's what I'm going to say.
What are you going to say?
Here's what I'm going to say.
For you right now.
I'm going to invite. What?
I need some tape for his mouth.
What are you going to do, Judge James?
I didn't hear what he said, but here's what I'm saying.
No, I can read it.
I want to invite President and Michelle Obama and their two daughters to come and stay with us in our house. I got plenty of room.
You do?
They stay upstairs. And we can make one of my Bama room can be the Oval Office for temporary.
Why don't you just walk in there and invite them?
I just want to, I want to invite them. They'd be safe here. Floyd Johnson, Chief Johnson, does a great job protecting the city.
I'm not a fan of any of them.
Sheriff Blakely does a great job.
You, it is the president.
Can I finish my statement?
Hurry up.
I want to invite them to Athens, Alabama. They can stay. And I don't ever let nobody stay overnight at my
house. They're not watching.
I'll let them stay.
On purpose.
You know, do you really want him that protected?
Yes.
Yes.
He is the president.
Why? He's the president.
Well, wait a minute.
You got to protect the office of the president.
He's the president of the United States.
And if we can't keep the president safe, that's
don't isolate that.
Be very careful.
Even though I don't agree with almost anything.
Well, don't you think that this man should be enough related to the public that the mass majority of the public should be on his side? And the simple fact of the matter is, they are so not like us. That there's a bunch of people that hate him for that reason.
Well, there's a lot of people probably hate me too, but at least they ain't watching this.
The office of the president, whether you like the guy or not, you have to protect the office of the president.
You got to protect the office of the president.
You got to still respect, and you still got to hope, because if you can't protect the president, how you expect to protect
the country?
Yeah, the country. I mean, that guy just jumped over the fence, went straight on.
How did he not get shot or have the dogs turned loose?
So y'all agree with me? He should come here and spend a weekend. I don't care what day of the week
That's not what I thought you were going to say. I thought you were going to say you were going to sell him your house because it would be such a protected environment.
No, I want it. I don't want to get rid of the house that bad, but if he's got some jack on him, I'd take it.
He's got some.
If President Obama and his family were to come and stay with me, even though I would never vote for him or any other Democrat running for president, he could come and live with us for a temporary.
Temporary.
Please have me on the show that day.
Secret Service could be out there at his police department, but he could stay upstairs. He could have our whole upstairs.
Me and Frank will be outside patrolling. Hold on. Now,
and Michelle could tell us what we're going to eat.
In this guy's office,
there
are proven communists. There are proven Muslim Brotherhood members. Look at who he surrounds himself with to begin with.
Seth,
there's not dangerous people walking around.
The only way we're going to be able to control that is in 2 years. Right now, I'm saying the guy needs to be protected.
Well,
I'm giving him a safe haven.
You have to protect him from his...
Seth, can I talk about me for a moment? I'm offering him a safe haven to come to Athens, Alabama. And yes, Zach.
You remember Andy Griffin? You know, we had Barney and Otis and all them. I said, me and Frank and Brad will be out there with guns. Out patrolling your front.
First, I don't want none of y'all three at my house. I don't even want none of y'all three at my house, period. The Obamas are welcome to come to my house.
You have opened up your home to the president.
That's right.
Jamie, you're a bigger man.
You're making that
right. That's what I wanted you to say, Dee.
Athens Police Department can.
And they can go to Lindsay Lane Church, Baptist Church with us and just hang out down
and
there with us.
You walk next door and see Bill, you can introduce him to Bill. I mean, it'd be perfect.
Well, that's right. Bill already knows Sean Hannity.
Well, there you go. They could get an exclusive interview. He could have Sean down to the house.
Speaking of that, yesterday, I'm watching Paul Feinbaum. They got a fantastic show, I got to say. And I hear this very great talker on. I said, man, they must have found some student or something. It was Shep Smith. Shepard was on there. He old Miss graduate.
Yeah.
Zach, what you got?
Good article in Decatur Daily on Coach Creasy and his son Jake and his stepson Paxton about how they're trying to get back on the road after a tough last few weeks. But I know they're working hard and they'll get that together. I sure is probably a pretty good household sitting there talking a lot of football during the day. Congratulations to Ardmore, ribbon cutting ceremonies yesterday.
We were all invited.
I know, I forgot all about it. They had the ribbon cutting on their new gym. They say
don't we know the football coach up there?
Yeah, I'm sure he'll talk about it tomorrow. But they say that thing is incredible. It's state of the art, one of the nicest ones around. Hey, congratulations, Coach Pugh and East Limestone. They got their highest rating, number 8 in 5A. And they play Tom's old school, Russellville, number 4, this Friday night. So that'd be a big...
All right, Zach, enough about you. Let's talk about me. What have I got?
Let's see a photo.
That's me and Matthew Cow down Chick-fil-A. Yes, let me hold that picture. We take some Chick-fil-A. Gloria's got some aunts visiting from Chicago. Never, ever, ever tasted Chick-fil-A.
What?
That's what kind of people I'm married into.
You're expanding their horizon.
What we got next?
So we had to take them to bed.
Got to give a shout out to Leon and Joan yesterday. I tell you what, if it ain't folks like Sheila and Don, look at that. Boiled okra, fried okra salad. Man, I mean, just excellent food. Now, any of y'all want to invite us over, Mr. and Ms. Paul Irons, I'm eating at everybody's house in that.
Oh, my goodness.
Y'all know I like fried okra and stuff like that.
Can't but eat all that fried
too.
Stuff.
You can come to Hillsboro. I cook for you.
I don't want to eat nothing you cook. Let me take a break. We'll come back. We'll play the number one rated game show in the history of Athens Town.
Woo-hoo!
Judge Jamie, it's all about me. Oh. Y'all, hang on. Let's get a picture. I got loaded.
Gonna love me.